Good evening, everyone. How you doing? My name is Mac McKinnon, and I am very honored to be the master of ceremony to welcome the students, family, and staff to our 2020 Mount Clemens High School graduation ceremony. At this time, we will honor our country with the playing of the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask you to please rise, remove your caps as the Star Spangled Banner is being played.
Find the answer.
High school has not always been easy for me, but I made it here today because of a great support system. Thank you to Nevaeh, Adam, Otis, Agent A, and many other friends who helped push me through high school.
You're welcome.
While we stay here today. After losing my dad in 2019, I started to wonder, how can I step up to be the man of the family while still being in school? With my brother, because two is always better than one. We stepped up together to take care of our family and be great and show example for our family. Thank you, Chance, for being the best brother I can have and the best mom we can have. I would like to thank my sisters, Sally, Timmy, for the craziness. Always make me laugh. To Maya, thank you for being the sweetheart of the family and for busting out a few rhymes for me so I can steal them and say I made them up. Mariah, thank you for taking care of us and getting us out of our comfort zone and getting us to experience new things. Every one of you in this attendance tonight, I owe a special thank you, and you have always made an impact on the graduates who sit here today, collectively, and now part of each other's past, present, and future. Our first speaker tonight is someone who knows Mount Clemens very well, after graduating in 1901. After graduating in 1988. He attended Western Michigan University and earned a bachelor's degree in history, social science, education, and then he received his master's in secondary teaching from Saginaw Valley. Mr. Mark Bates. Mr. Mark Bates have dedicated his last 25 years to this district. He has taught every secondary grade 6 through 12. The list of classes that he have taught is extraordinary history, reading, economics, government, African American studies, global studies, civics, sociology, and psychology, even computers. Who can ever imagine Mr. Bates teaching a computer class? That would have been interesting, though. Mr. Bates is an energetic and a passionate teacher. His contact knowledge is unmatched. This graduation is Mr. Bates' last as a Mount Clemens Community School teacher. It is with an honor to introduce a pillar of the district as he reflects on his years to service to Mount Clemens Community School, Mr. Bates.
Well, I was born here in 1969, and I went to Wade Fast Elementary, and I'm sure there's a few people out there that remember Wade Fast. This is now the Montessori on Harrington. And I went to Seminole Middle School, back when we had two middle schools. And then I came here in 1984 and got to attend Mount Clemens High School. It was one of the best years of my life. The kids ask, if you could ever go back, when would you go back in years? And I say, 10th grade was the greatest year of my life. Got my driver's license, had all my friends in one place. And I'd like to remind you to look around right now, because you don't know if you're ever going to be around the same people you are right now. So take this moment and remember it, because I remember those days with my friends, and I miss it. I really do. Graduated in 1988, went off to college, the first time I had ever been out of Mount Clemens in my life to live somewhere else. Got to come back after I graduated, and I actually subbed in Mount Clemens for over a year, and then went to my first job in Vassar High School. Unfortunately, I got laid off after a couple years of teaching, and I came back to Mount Clemens, and I went to a bachelor party of all things, and lo and behold, there's my old principal, bunch of teachers, Mr. Fargo, those of you who went to Mount Clemens, and the superintendent, Mr. Archibald. And they said, what are you doing? And I said, well, I just got laid off. And they're like, what's your degree in? And I told them, they said, send a resume over. So I did. I got a call 2 days later for an interview. Came in, and who was the interview? Person I graduated with, an old teacher, an old counselor, an old principal. And I'm like, well, this is kind of nice because everybody knows me. And lo and behold, I got a contract and came back to Mount Clemens. I went to work in the middle school where I taught for 7 years, every grade, 6th, 7th, and 8th. And then I transferred back to the high school where I've been ever since. And looking back now at all these people that I had in my classes, I have all these people from on Facebook that I still communicate with. And it's great still to see this fantastic pride still that people have in Mount Clemens. We've shrunk a lot, but there are still people who are diehard bathers. Once you're a bather, you're always a bather, right? You guys remember that. And I have people like our speaker here tonight, who is going to be talking to you shortly. I had his sister and him. I got to coach him as well as have him in class. His parents are fantastic people, and I've made connections, and I'm still here in Mount Clemens. I moved back, I live here, I'm still in the school district, I will support it to the day I die, because you can't get the bather out of you once you've been a part of it. And I'm sad to say that I'm leaving, but I will still be here, and I will still be a part of this school forever.
Thank you, Mr. Bates, for the last lecture. speech. All of us students who were awake for the last one, no need to hit the desk on your way out. Mr. Bates, you have been a great role model for the community for the last 25 years. All of us here, staff, students alike, have been privileged to be a part of our journey here. Your impact will last many years after your retirement. Thank you for your dedication to the education of Mount Clemens students. Our next speaker may be familiar to you, as she made headlines several times recently. Not to be confused with Candace Parker, our valedictorian, Ms. Nevaeh Williams. Nevaeh is a genuine person, intelligent and giving. Nevaeh takes on many challenges given to her, academically or athletically. Her sports accomplishments are lengthy. She is a school county record holder for basketball, stepping out her comfort zone. Nevaeh also earned a spot as a track field state qualifier. Nevaeh plans to attend Davenport University and to fall and pursue a degree in legal studies and continue her career in basketball. Ladies and gentlemen, giving her our valedictorian, the one and only Sunshine Nevaeh Williams.
Good evening. It's with great honor that I'm able to address all of you as a valedictorian of the amazing class of 2022. I'd like to thank everyone who has come to support us on this great day of accomplishments in our young lives. On behalf of the class of 2022, I'd like to start by thanking our parents, our guardians, teachers, and supporters for doing everything in their power to get us to this point in our lives. From the simple words of encouragement before a test or quiz, countless meals, rides to and from school events and activities, they have been by our side through it all. We've all had so many memories from ninth grade until now. When Matt couldn't make a free throw to save his life in the pep rally games, from Miss Richard beating all of us in computer games during our free time in world history class, to the girls' basketball team winning their first district championship since the 2014-15 season. We have countless memories of times after school when we would all go out to eat, talk, and have fun. Even though we have great memories together, we also have our own high school experiences. We were just sophomores when the pandemic started, and it affected all of us. However, as a class and friends, we worked together to keep each other motivated and on task during those difficult times to reach our goals of graduating high school. And here we are today achieving those goals. We all have faced challenges and struggled at some point within these 4 years. We all go through challenges in life. Some we can see, and most that we can't. Most of you may know me as a basketball star who has lived and breathed basketball for the past 4 years. I guarantee none of you even realize that there was a time where I almost threw in the towel. A time where I struggled with belief in myself and being discouraged. Who inspired me and encouraged me to not give up was my mother. We will fight battles with being discouraged at times or not believing in ourselves, but that doesn't mean give up so easily. That means to persevere and succeed. Here's a quote from Madam C.J. Walker. Don't sit down and wait for the opportunities to come. Get up and make them. So to the class of 2022, this is not the end of our story. This just closes the chapter of high school and opens a new chapter of life. Often on graduation day, we look outside for heroes, but I see them right here amongst us. I have seen in my years at Mount Clemens High School that we don't have to look far for inspiration, and that we have the potential to make an inspiring contribution to others by being true to our values and committing ourselves to lofty goals. When you leave here today, celebrate what you have accomplished, but look forward with an eye how you too can be an inspiration for others. Congratulations, class of 2022.
She almost made me cry. Our next speaker is Matthew King. Mr. King attended Mount Clemens Public Schools for his entire K-12 graduation. Graduating in 2015 with over 1,700 community service hours, in January of 2022, Mr. King graduated from Central Michigan University as cum laude with a bachelor's degree in recreation with concentration in environment aspect. Mr. King has been volunteered across the nation with various organizations with a passion of racial justice and human rights. Mr. King is a multi-award winner speaker and workshop developer. Please give Mr. Matthew King a warm welcome back to Mount Clemens High School.
Set up real quick. I'm gonna bring this to the side. I'm gonna be looking at y'all. Yeah, I do. My city. Fear. Oh no. Oh no. I put the numbers on there for a reason. All right, let's go for round two. You got the. Thank you. At least it's in the very beginning, not in the middle or not at the end. Here, I got some clips of this. Thank you. Let me reorganize them real quick. Whew. All right. Take two. Fear. Everybody has them. They've told me so many. Planes, sharks, darkness, being left on red, aloneness, living a empty life, death. But I don't really fear that. My hometown, my birthplace, the people that raised me. I fear of forgetting my city. A place where one street separates the neighborhood from the hood. Where 50% of the residents is pale and say things are going good, and the other half live by the mentality of, I wish a brother would. In the suburban city of hoops, Miller Bros, Ben serving scoops, a Superman Sunday waffle cone, that's my roots. Curveball in the streets, riding bikes from police, Gus's Coney Island chili fries with the cheese, that's my city. I appreciate it if you say it with me. Clem Nation, of people that do not need your pity, that's my town, where Butch and the Bathers will throw down, and the king blood runs deep, y'all best respect the crown. That's my home. R.I.P. Destin, you're not alone. We've come a long ways from kids to being grown. I've been gone for what feels like way too long. My G's got freed and I celebrated alone. That's my fam, where Javon's catching jams, D's hitting threes and TCB's making plans. That's my soul, class reunion at the Rec Bowl, fireworks in the sky of July from the gazebo. That's me. I really wish others would see the Clem through my eyes and how it's molded me. That's my drive, taught me what it means to be alive, put respect on my city. That's the reason that I strive, put the shoes on my feet. The game's rolling deep. If you asking for a verse, this be a Bath City beat. Don't ask me to repeat. We only got the heat. Rocking the mic ain't a thing when you born in MC. You will never catch me sleep. To my people from the streets, at a table with a seat, that's everybody eats. I set a plate, fork, and a seat, a whole rack of meat. You won't never catch me sleep till everybody eats. I said I won't never count no sheep. To my homies from the streets, got some J's on their feet, a table and a seat, a whole rack of meat like a whole freaking feast. I said, you won't ever catch me sleep until everybody eats. Mount Clemens class of 2022, make some noise. Like they said, my name is Matthew King. I graduated from Mount Clemens High School in 2015. I just graduated from Central Michigan University with a bachelor's degree in January. And now I'm back home, getting on my career path, but more importantly, I'm back home to give back to a city and the people that have given so much to me. So, being here on this stage, being a part of this celebration, this is a complete come true and a serious honor. So thank y'all, and with that being said, let me get into the speech titled, Hope, a Work in Progress. I wrote that poem this past summer. Traveling across the country, I got extremely homesick in Colorado. So I wrote what home is to me. Another collection of words that holds extreme significance is a sentence I found 4 years ago. Doing homework, I stumbled upon this. High school graduation is the single most effective preventative strategy to adulthood poverty. When I hear that, and see, succeeding students walk across stage and receive their diplomas, I am moved. Graduating from Mount Clemens in 2015, I didn't know this statistic, and I didn't know my hometown enough to express it in any serious form. Let alone did I understand the tremendous importance of those two things and how they would have effect on my life in the following 7 years. You see, when I graduated, I flaunted a long list of achievements that I thought made me better than the average high school student. Over 1,700 volunteer hours, 15 local scholarships, 5 varsity sports, class president, accepted to Central Michigan University, Michigan Military Boys and Girls Club Youth of the Year, speaking awards, emceed my graduation, and my peers even voted me, most likely to become a billionaire. Unfortunately, they didn't know that I'd spend 6.5 years in college, where instead I'd end up exactly $1 billion in debt. In an old conversation with a friend, I explained, I lived in Mount Clemens for 18 years. I know who I am and what I want. I've done my fair share of community service. I know all the streets, all the people, and everything else that comes a part of being a part of a community. I convinced myself that after graduation, I should leave my city because there was nothing more it could offer me, or nothing more I could offer it. I thought to myself, my work here is done. That egocentric belief fractured within my first month of living on campus at Central. Coming from a high school that was 90% black, I wasn't surprised to see less people of color on campus. What caught me off guard was that I was one of only 2 black people that lived on my entire floor. And out of my entire dorm of over 100 students, there was maybe 8 others that looked like me. The cracks of my know-it-all belief further spread when others compared class sizes to see who graduated with the most hundreds of students. The conversation slowly came to a silence. I shifted to my direction, and I merely whispered, 37? My old belief splintered from top to bottom. When I spoke of having so many meal options in our new campus cafeteria, only for my new peers to say, this is nice, but we used to get whatever we wanted from chain restaurants in our high school lunchrooms. Which at first made me bring up how that wouldn't fly in my school because we all got free lunch. But then I learned to press my lips because I was told that free lunch for an entire school was only possible if over 80% of students lived under the poverty line. The culmination of all these experiences in this new community where I was the oddball out forced enough pressure for my cracked up belief to shatter into 1,000 pieces. On a beautiful day, I ran across campus with watered up eyes, unlocked my dorm room, turned off the lights, threw my bags to the floor, and curled up into a ball on my bed. I hid from the world as I cried and cried and cried. At the time, I couldn't put words to what was wrong with me. You see, my entire life growing up in Mount Clemens and attending our public schools, I didn't recognize the many adaptations that were made to our everyday lives. Adaptations we were forced to make due to the systematic biases that affect predominantly black and brown communities.
And when everyone is going through the same struggle, it becomes extremely difficult to recognize the effects those challenges have on a personality and your identity. Now that I entered a new world that had never faced the issues my friends and I did, I began to grasp the impact those effects had on me. I realized that my old claim of knowing everything about myself and where I'm from was blissfully ignorant. Now that I was awakened to this new reality, it was impossible for me to look back. I could only move forward where there was a mountain of work to be done. I'd begin this work by searching for stories, people, or any medium that could shine a light into the cracks of my foundation. In part, help me explain the community I came from, therefore, pieces of who I am. My first step was listening to the world-famous writers with firsthand experience of similar struggles. Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, Joey Badass. I tried to listen to Drake, but that's when he was like making the emotional music and I had already cried in my room for multiple days, so I was trying to move past that. That taught me that although different people from different corners of our country, other communities existed similar to my hometown. I made friends, turned mentors on campus that spoke in the same tongue as me and opened my eyes to the injustices they were facing as full-time students, some even with full-time jobs. They taught me that, yes, we have emotions too, but some groups of people have less time to weep in order to work for the world that we deserve. I scheduled courses that taught the history and roots of oppression in America to find out how our country got here, and by consequence, my hometown. These taught me of redlining, a practice in the 40s and 50s to segregate communities by race, deeming black homes worth less, denying blacks from purchasing homes in white neighborhoods, and providing white families with home loans, denying blacks that same support. I imagined the Gratiot roads stained red. I was taught of white flight, where white families with the financial power to do so move out of urban areas that have a significant minority population. I fantasized of doves departing my alma mater, flying down Cass and Crocker roads to newly nest at Lance Cruz, Chippewa, even Dakota. I learned of the Black Panther Party, a group organized in the 60s who provided street surveillance on officers in black communities during a time of extreme police brutality based upon race, and how they were the catalyst for free school breakfasts and lunches around the world. I daydreamed a full plate of pasta and chicken for dinner, when in reality, being a broke college student, I slathered peanut butter on the bread for the third night in a row. Nevertheless, in that flawed foundation of mine, friends, artists, and history showed me that my base of which to build was not to be scrapped, but to be intentionally pieced back together, inspecting bit by bit to ensure the future of any storms that may come. And with that realization, I noted, there is more work to be done. With better understanding the roots of America, Mount Clemens and myself, a flame of passion was ignited. I couldn't keep these valuable lessons locked up. I needed to apply them. I chose to volunteer. I headed to Flint during the water crisis where we supported in the cleanup and restoration of an elementary school. I traveled to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, where we assisted in putting homes back together after a historical flood. New York City, learning how to best support and advocate for our LGBT plus friends, families, and neighbors. Omaha, Nebraska, providing emergency services such as shelters, clothes, and meals for youth, Asheville, North Carolina, and Homestead, Florida, working to protect natural lands and waters through nature conservation, Sharpsburg, Georgia, farming to provide nutritious meals combating the effects of cancer on patients, even El Hotel, Honduras, building latrines with hand-washing stations and teaching healthy hygiene practices. I went to all these places and worked with all these organizations with one intent, to give. However, with every experience, I received something as well. I noticed that the organizations making the largest meaningful changes for the people of their community were ran by people from their communities. They knew the unique challenges that affected their cities and areas because they grew up through it too, which meant they had the best understanding of anyone in the world to solve their community's specific issues. This lesson I received from these monumental community leaders was something I promised to bring home and that I would adopt. And with this, I noticed there is more work to be done. This promise of mine was brought home that summer of 2019. In the midst of a police pursuit, I stood only feet away from a cornered young black high school boy. With nowhere else to run, the boy froze, and a white middle-aged officer roared, "Lay on your effing stomach and put your hands behind your head." Scowling and mouthing off, the boy slowly dropped to one knee, and then the other, following the command. The officer slowly circled around the laid-out boy and quickly dropped to one knee, digging into the boy's back. Wincing in pain, he was swiftly cuffed. Suddenly, I heard tires screeching. I turned to see a squad car jumping the curb only feet from where I stood. Two officers burst from the door. The white middle-aged officer's face turned bright red and animated as he repeatedly thrust his knee into the boy's back, all the while screaming, "Where did you hide the effing shoes? Where the F is your buddy? Don't give me that BS." Sensing another sharp knee on his way, the boy jerked his body and rolled to the side. Reacting to the boy's quick movement, the officer grabbed his gun. My heart sank without a thought. My hands openly raised into the air. My voice boomed, "Chill." Everyone froze. The officer looking to me with a face of regret, holstered his gun and rose to his feet. The boy's tense body relaxed from a state of panic to a sense of calm. The other officers assisted in standing the boy up and placing him in the police car. As the boy looked to me, as the boy entered the car, he looked at me one last time and nodded. Change made by one community member. My promise to enact community change. My promise to enact community change persisted through COVID-19. The whole world suffering together only for the lives of Ahmaud Arbery and George Floyd to be lost. As the entire world took to the streets in protests, living with my mother, I feared for her health. I anxiously sat at home questioning how else I could possibly help. Then it hit me, a scholarship. Although I had no medical expertise to offer or political power to enforce, I had a little money saved up, an army of friends and family that truly support what I fight for. I typed out my vision. Imagine a community where everyone invests $50, $500, or $1,000 towards their young adults. Every single kid would be in a better place to become a successful member of their communities. Once they're financially established, they would then be able to invest in the next group of young adults and so on. This would lead to a healthier, more successful community. After the vision, I created applications for students, put $500 of my own aside, created a Cash App, Venmo, GoFundMe, and posted all the information across my social media platforms. 8 months, 57 plus donors, and $3,500 later, I gave out 7 scholarships worth $500 each to 7 first-generation college students from my hometown, the first ever recipients of the Everybody Eats scholarship, and the most empowering moment of my life. This year, people across Michigan, Illinois, New York, in your hands, you hold the hope of a new generation of leaders, trailblazers, discoverers, problem solvers, and so much more. This hope does not rest on the great work you have already done, but the resounding work you will do. Carving career paths that our ancestors could only imagine. Building bridges to ensure opportunity and optimism to flourish. Building roads and carving careers that laying the foundation for roads and paths that will give way to new hope, new leaders, and a new generation of great students. My friends of all races, of gender and non-gender, religious or not, there is more work to be done. As my favorite author, Casey Gerald, says, hard work, frightening work, uncertain work, unending work, work that may test us, work that may defeat us, work that may not even, that we may not even get the credit for, but work on which the whole world depends. My fellow graduates, with the love of your families, with the support of your friends, with the bond of your city, and with a worldwide network of people who believe in you, this work, no matter how tough, cannot help but be done. This work, us kids from the Clem know better than anybody else. Mount Clemens, class of 2022, congratulations on this phenomenal accomplishment, and I cannot wait to see the work you do. Thank y'all.
Appreciate you, man. They crazy.
Thank you, Matt King. It is now time for the presentation of the class of 2022. Entrusted with this is Mr. Duncan, Mount Clemens Secondary Complex Principal.
Almost got me too, Matthew. Caught it. The wind is just tearing stuff up here. All right, so good afternoon, bathers, family. I am Kirk Duncan, the principal of Mount Clemens Secondary Complex Middle and High School. I'd like to start by congratulating our graduating class, the school board, central building administration, teachers, support personnel, and families. We survived yet another crazy school year. So let's give ourselves a round of applause. Well earned. I would like to thank Jay and the grounds crew for getting everything together. And we had a whole lot more decorations, but as you can see, the wind is kind of carrying those things away. I'd like to thank Emily Wallace, Daniela Richard, for putting together a wonderful week for our graduating class from honors night to graduation. It's a lot of work and a lot of headaches to put something together like this. So a round of applause for those two, please. I'd also like to thank Ms. Hickson for her tireless efforts in dragging a few of these across the finish line. Ms. Hickson, you've done a wonderful job, and everyone seated to my right is going to remember you forever for everything that you did for them. This group of graduates that you see over here. I've done something no one here in attendance has done. They have endured 2.5 years of many starts and stops, remote learning, hybrid learning, close contact or COVID positive quarantines, and many more personal and physical, social emotional tests that we may never know about in their personal lives, but they endured, they persevered, and they've made it to those seats today, despite a lot of odds stacked against them, many obstacles, subtractions of normalcy. You add the anxiety-inducing political, social, and economic news cycles, and the tragic events in our nation's schools, including one very close to our hearts in our home in Oxford. None of that made it any easier. That's why them graduating is different. They went through something different than the rest of us to get here today. You should be proud of yourself. Despite all that, we are doing better than we think we are. This is a phrase that came to mind in January when, you know, year's getting long, everyone's getting a little tired, but we were doing better than we thought. Returning to school this year was tough for everybody. Everyone came back different, and it took a while to settle in. It took time for everyone, some more than others, to readjust and remember how to actually do school. Some took way too long. Some of you took way too long to figure it out, but you did, and you made it. And I saw the shift, I saw it. Saw it in November, January. I saw lights starting to turn on. I saw teachers digging in, trying new strategies and practices and sharing their learnings with each other. And then I saw our students engage with their learning differently and think deeper than they had before. We were doing better than we think we were. So graduates, as you take the step forward, I beg you to always, always, no matter the darkest day, to find the good, look for it, and know that you are doing better than you think you are. You will find a life of fulfillment and full of life if you seek those choices that will bring you light. You will be doing better than you think you are. I promise you. So, Board President Rickman, it is my distinct honor to present this very special graduating class to you, the Board of Education, whereas they have successfully satisfied or exceeded the graduation requirements set forth by the State of Michigan and the Mount Clemens Board of Education. The alumni, teachers, and staff, past and present, and community should all stand proud as this group walks the stage, receives their diplomas, flips that tassel, and becomes graduates of Mount Clemens High School. Congratulations, class of 22. I couldn't be more proud. Mr. Rickman.
On behalf of the Mount Clemens Board of Education, I'm honored and privileged to stand before you this evening. I'd be remiss if I did not introduce my colleagues that we serve together on the Board of Education. They're sitting to my left, your right, Ms. Trustee Jamie Collins, Trustee Stephanie O'Neill, Vice President Dr. David McFadden, Secretary, Mr. Jason Monk, Treasurer, Ms. Janine Walker. These are the members of the Mount Clemens Board of Education. To the talented faculty, thank you for your hard work and dedication in providing a quality education under very challenging and at times seemingly impossible situations for these graduating seniors sitting here this evening. To the parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts, sisters, brothers, nieces, nephews, cousins, caregivers, and extended family members. Special thanks goes out to you because these graduating students didn't make it here this evening by themselves. You played a very important role in their lives. Thank you for being there for them. Yeah, give yourself a round of applause. You deserve it. To the members of the Mount Clemens High School graduating class of 2022, we are here this evening to celebrate your accomplishments. You have survived and continue to survive a global pandemic that changed not only the way you received your educational instructions, but also changed how you live your life. COVID-19 presented challenges never witnessed in modern history. This world crisis changed every aspect of everyone's life forever. The class of 2022, each of you exemplified qualities of willing to learn, willing to listen, willing to change and adjust how you think, willing to do things differently to achieve your goal of graduation here this evening. Each of you exemplified the abilities to think critically and apply critical thinking skills. Each of you exemplifies persistence, the ability to persist despite setbacks and disappointments. Your persistence is valuable. Persistence should be the iron quality of your character. So I would like every member of the graduating class of 2022 to stand. And I'm gonna ask you to repeat after me. I'm gonna say a line and then you say it back. So, upon receiving my graduation this evening, my life will never be the same. Never, never, never. I confirm and affirm my ability to control my destiny. My destiny is about respect and priority. I'm committed to respecting myself, my family, my profession, and my community. I further commit to respecting the thoughts, ideas, and rights of others. My past was interesting. However, my future is pure excitement filled with endless possibilities. My future is pure excitement filled with endless possibilities. My potential is in my expectations. My potential is in my expectations. It pays to do good. It doesn't cost anything to think big. It doesn't cost nothing to think big. It don't cost nothing to think. Repeat it. Repeat it. Yeah. It doesn't cost anything to think big. So think big. Real big. You may be seated. The class of 2022, you are the hope for tomorrow today. Become the change you want to see and be. Go change the world. Superintendent Beals, Principal Duncan, by the power vested in me by the state of Michigan, I affirm these students have met all requirements for graduation, and on behalf of the Mount Clemens Board of Education, I accept and receive these students for graduation. Congratulations, class of 2022. Once a bather, always a bather.
Good evening. Hi, y'all. My name is Danielle Stevens. Beside me is Miss Amanda Sizemore. We have the honor of announcing names tonight as your graduates walk across the stage. This group of young men and women, they are very special to the two of us. In 2015, I, after 7 years at the high school, was moved to the middle school as they entered sixth grade. And there was a lot of tears, frustration, apprehension, and that was just me. They felt the same way, but we made it through together. Ms. Sizemore had a similar experience when they entered freshman year. So again, we are honored to announce their names tonight. Ready to graduate? If you're ready. Nevaeh Sunshine Williams.
Willow Lucille Beck.
Nazeah Brand.
Yeah, you already know.
Xavier Maurice Braxton.
Desari Lazar Chastang.
Asianae Crampton.
Kimberly Dominguez.
Jordan James Durham.
Blake Michael Evans.
Antonia Griffin.
Cameron Henderson.
Christopher Kazabowski.
Yeah. Tamaya Maxwell.
Bradley James McDerris.
Adam McHaskell.
Mac McKinnon.
Zachary Papineau.
Alicia Porritt.
Otis Lee Porritt the third.
Jamal Oldies Sneed.
Johnny Lee Sneed Jr.
Dorothy Strait.
Ani Swope.
Nicholas D. J. Terrell.
Kiana Thacker.
Aaliyah Wynn.
Kia Chanel Wright.
Let's give another round of applause for the class of 2022. Let's give a round of applause for our master of ceremony, Mac McKinnon. He's going to close us out.
before I get started, I want to thank everyone for taking their precious time coming out to see us walk across the stage. Love y'all too. At this time, I would like to thank someone important, some important women who always been believed in me, Miss Martin, Miss Hickson, Miss Stevens, Miss Hannah, Miss Nickel, Miss Monk, and Thug Richards. These ladies have been the moms I needed while I was in the building. Thank you to my mom, Miss Neely, and my grandma for supporting me everywhere I turn. Class of 2022, at this time, at the moment, we are at a time of a junction in our lives. We are remembering the tears, tiredness, trophies, and trials of our last 4 years. While we are also celebrating what we earned, we're excited, eager to do great things with this diploma. We're headed into the future, beyond high school, hopefully honored and humbled. Our past, present, and future all come together on this day. And now, to my friends, family, classmates of class of 2022, I am honored to lead you in the movement of our tassel as we symbolize our graduation. Please remove your tassel from the right and to the left. Thank you to the graduating class of 2022. Self-made out, baby.